Krishna's ornaments, Krishna's cloth, Krishna's house. The associates of Krishna, including Krishna's mother and father, millions of sakhis and satis, is also manifested by Baladev. So he's expanded all paraphernalia for Krishna's service. So that Baladev takes responsibility for Goloka Vrindavan. Then that Baladev expands again as the first expansion in Mathura, where he takes the form of Sankarshan. Then Mathura means Dwarka, same thing. And then he comes in the second quadruple expansion in Vaikuntha. So means all the varieties of the spiritual world, the unlimited Vaikunthas, is also manifested, Giridhari, by Baladev Guru in the form of Sankarshan. Then Sankarshan manifests, this Mahasankarshan manifests in the form of Mahavishnu. Mahavishnu is so huge, the universes come from the pores of his skin. As he breathes out, that is the creation. As he breathes in, that is the destruction. Then again, he manifests in each universe. He enters each universe in the form of Gavadaksai Vishnu. And then he expands further into every atom in the form of Kiridaksai Vishnu. So everything material and everything spiritual exists, rests, takes shelter of Baladev Guru. Okay? So, we offer pranam to him again and again. He is like our father. He is the origin of Shambhu. Shambhu means father. So Gurudev would say, Baladev is like a farmer. As the farmer produces varieties of seeds and vegetables, so in the same way, Baladev produces many varieties of souls for the service of Krishna. In Goloka Vrindavan, he manifests the eternally perfected souls, the Nitya Siddha Parikas of Krishna. These are manifested by Baladev. Then in Vaikuntha, also many associates are needed for service. Baladev, in the form of Sankarshan, manifests them. And in this world, the unlimited, what they call, the unlimited individual souls, okay, try and stay away from the intergender. So that is called the Vibhidang Satattva. That is also manifested by Sankara, by this Mahavishnu. So in other words, he's manifesting countless souls for the service of Krishna. So despite manifesting everyone else for the service of Krishna, he also wants to do some service. Therefore he's serving in so many varieties of ways. No. So there's no difference between Krishna and Balaram. Only difference is their complexion. Krishna is dark and Baladev is white. Baladev like a crystal elephant, as described. Whitish complexion. So he also becomes the older brother of Krishna, even though he's Krishna's expansion. As said in previous, in the pastimes of Ram, Lord Ram, when Krishna appeared as the older brother, then Baladev appeared as the younger brother, Lakshmi. So because Lakshmi was the younger brother, many services he had to do which he was not too much satisfied. For example, Sita had no fault, but some gossip was there. Chismes, some gossip was there. What gossip? Sita had spent 11 months in the house of Ravana. Was her character perfect or not? Some doubt was there. So because it said Caesar's wife should be beyond suspicion, Ravana was forced to reject Sita. Therefore, who did that service, Gopal? It's not enough just to be here, you have to be conscious also. Therefore, Lakshman was given that service to take Sita on the other side of the Ganga and cast her away. So Lakshman was not very happy to do that seva, Bala. So So therefore, Lakshman was forced to take Sita and put on the other side of the Ganga, but Lakshman was not satisfied, not happy by that step. Therefore, Lakshman made a vow, next time I come, I never come as younger brother, I will always come as the older brother. So we see in the pastimes of Krishna, he came as the older brother, Balaram, and the pastimes of Gosunda, who he came with as Giri? Nitai. So Balaram is very wonderful, very kind. So, what can we say? So, today is full moon. When full moon rises, all ignorance is removed. So Baladeva, as the original guru, appears on this day. And full moon gives so much cooling, so much relief. So in this world, all souls have so much suffering. Adhyatmik, adhibautik, adhidekavita. In this world, everyone is suffering. And for that one, 2 moments we're not suffering, we call that happiness. That is just another form of ignorance. So, Baladev gives shelter to the souls in this world. Those souls who have some change of heart. All souls, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, all souls born into the womb of ignorance. That any soul that comes to the material world comes here because ignorant. But some soul has a change of heart by the influence of Sadhusanga, by the influence of the holy place like Vrindavan, the influence of association of Vaishnavas, then some fortunate soul develops a change of heart. Nijatattva jani samsaya nahi chai kenona bojino maya kuri hai hai. Understanding who am I am not this body, I am the soul. I am Krishna's eternal servant, but I have forgotten him. And instead of serving Krishna, I am serving this creation. That time the fortunate soul laments why I did such a mistake. I talujaki kinkaran patitam mama sabi guru kripaya mitapada pankita stiti lumika saya vachanta chaitanya mahaprabhu told us to pray in shikshastra. I nanda dhanuja, O Krishna, I am your eternal servant. Somehow I have forgotten you. I have become separate from you. I have been cast into this ghastly ocean of birth, death, old age and disease. And Krishna again picked me up and put me as a fixed speck of dust on your lotus feet. So please let your servant serve you. That time, without strength, you cannot serve Krishna. Sorry, should I turn the volume down? Narayamatma Prabhachanena Ladya Namedaya Nabhuna Shuddha. Parakure would call this verse. The weak soul cannot serve Krishna. So who gives this strength given by Guru, especially Baladeva? Because he's the presiding deity of strength and existence. Balaram, Bala means strength. So by worshipping, by the mercy of Baladeva, the souls of this world develop some inspiration, some strength to do bhajan, to serve Krishna. So especially Baladeva's power enters some devotee in this world, that person functions as Guru. So by taking shelter of Guru, by listening to the instructions of Vaishnavas, especially to stay awake in their class, also needs some strength. They are sleeping, this needs no strength, no taste. So validate all these feelings of taste, inspiration, strength, determination, giving up material desires. This whole strength comes from Baladev Guru. So Baladev too much important for us. So who neglect this Baladev Jayanti, who neglect how they can get service of Bhagavan, making possible. So here we are, Baladev, too many, he has also too many activities in the pastimes of Krishna. So sometimes it seems Baladev acts against Krishna. Sometimes it may appear like that. But this is not so, this is just the influence of yoga maya, and also to make Krishna's pastimes more tasty, more astonishing. Rasa sa chamaka. If there's no astonishment, there's no taste, no wonderment, no ras. So to increase the rasa of Krishna Lila, Krishna's second body, Balaram, sometimes it seems he acts against Krishna, but it's not like that. This is just aparavicha, apparent consideration, but it's not tapavicha, not by philosophy. One such example, I always remember this day, within the first day Gurudev made me speak in public, in Room Sananta. I remember this day. And I was so nervous.
I remember.
So nervous that no pranam to do nothing, just how all I speak, one like fear was there. So I always remember this day so much. So there was one, Balarama took part in this Mahabharata war. Didi often said, Krishna liked to fight, he liked too much, fighting, making trouble. But Baladev's nature is different. Baladev, because Guru is equal to everyone. So Baladev not took part in the Mahabharata war, but Krishna too much involved. Actually, Krishna doing everything. But Baladev don't want part of this. So Baladev, before the war, he left. Because Baladev had two disciples, main disciple. One is Bhim, the son of Pandu, and the other one is Duryodhan, the son of Dhritarashtra. So Baladev teaching both of them club fighting. Some may say, well, Duryodhan is a great demon and completely opposed to Bhagavan and his devotees. Pramila, happy customer. Yes. Okay, let us see. I've never seen anyone that much happy in Katari full unconscious. So, Baladev, why he gave so much mercy to Duryodhan? Duryodhan is a great demon. And Baladev accepted him and taught him fighting. This is like a mystery. It's because Baladev was partial to both sides. He not took part in the war. So he left and went on Tita Yatra. Baladev went visiting all holy places. But one nature of Baladev is great servant of Bhagavan. So Baladev too much liked to hear Harikatha. That's his life and soul. One expansion of Baladev, his name is Anantashesh. Ananta has thousands of mouths. And with thousands of mouths, he's speaking Krishna's name, form, qualities, and pastimes. So Baladev liked to hear Harikatha. So that time was one personality. His name was Romahashan Sut. So I think he was disciple of Vyasadeva. And he was very expert in speaking the Puranas. Very expert. So when he was speaking the Puranas, then many, many thousands of rishis came to hear from him. That time Baladev also entered the arena of the Harikatha. So Baladev is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Maharaj says, Baladev, Krishna only eats off one plate in Joya, but Baladev has two plates. Baladev has mood of God, but Baladev also has mood, I am servant of God. So Visaya and Ashray both mood during Balarama. So when Balarama entered the Harikatha, everyone stood up to offer respect. Just like when the curtain opens, everyone stands up, everyone does pranam, everyone bows, because the great person, Radha Krishna, have come. So everyone stands up. Even material life, if the Prime Minister or some important person comes, everyone stands up. So when Baladev entered the arena of the Harikatha, everyone stood up to respect Balaram, the Supreme Lord. But Romahashan Sut did not stand up. Romahashan Sut was, actually he'd taken the position of Guru, but was not qualified. Because the position of Guru means to glorify Bhagavan. But instead of glorifying Bhagavan, he was more interested in glorifying himself. So when Baladev came, he not stood up to respect Balaram. That means you are illegally occupying the position of Guru. Because the position of Guru is to expand the service of Krishna. So Balaram, being dissatisfied by his behavior, Balaram cut off his head with a piece of grass. It may sound impossible. How could someone kill someone with a piece of grass? But Baladev can make the impossible possible because God. So Balaram killed him. Then all the rishis became sad. Now we cannot hear Harikatha. So all the rishis became disappointed. And also the rishis had given a benediction to Guru Maharshi. He would have a long life. But Balaram had cancelled the benediction because God means not controlled by anyone, independent. So Baladev killed him. So the rishis became sad because now, main one, we cannot hear Harikatha. And second, we had given benediction, but that benediction is now nullified, reversed, ineffective. So all the rishis prayed to Balaram, please give mercy, please give mercy. Then Balaram said, what do you want? I cut off his head and killed him, but I can bring him to life as well. He said, nothing impossible for Balaram. So the rishi said, no, we're not complaining that, but we cannot hear Harikatha. So Roma Harshan Sut had one son. His name was Sutta. Also another name was Ugrasrava. Shrava means to hear. Ugrasrava means he was a very ferocious hearer of Harikatha. Sometimes in his Katha Maharaj jokes, a person who hears guitar is called a shrota, right? But someone who sleeps is called a sota. So sometimes, mostly in guitar Maharaj, there are no shrotas, only sotas, sleepers. So Ugrasrava, the qualification which he liked to hear guitar too much. Actually, Chirukha Maharaj said to Mahabhagavata today, and someone says to a Mahabhagavata, Harimau Maharaj. The Mahabhagavata, no, look, he's so unqualified. Who is he to say Haribol? But he hears the holy name and thinks my life is successful and he feels ecstasy. So we are little, not so good hearers. We look, both the guitar is very ornamented and so many nice verses, and I like this guy, so I'm tasting him. This is ordinary type of ruchi. If someone who has very high class of ruchi in guitar, they don't even look, this person is low, this person is boring. No? We take our own pulse, we see, fail. Anyhow, topics of Krishna, there they feel ecstasy no matter who is speaking. This means high taste of ruchi. Sometimes we get a bit extreme taste in that. Baladev said the son is considered the representative of the father. So Baladev said, I transfer the benediction you gave to Roma Harshan Sut. I transfer that benediction to his son, Ugrasrava, or Sut Goswami. Then Baladev blessed that boy. He was only 5 years old. And by the blessing of Baladev, all the Vedanta, all the Upanishads, all Puranas, the direct seva of Balwan, everything appeared in the heart of that small boy. And he became famously known as Sut Goswami. I was reading the other night, Bhagavan Goswami Maharaj writing a letter. Pariksit Maharaj heard the Bhagavad Gita from Sukadev Goswami 200 years after the disappearance of Krishna. Sukadev Goswami spoke this Bhagavad Gita to the sages of Namasaranya 300 years after. So by the blessings of Balaram, even a small boy became great knower of all the Vedas. Therefore we pray to Guru. What is that? We pray to Guru. Mukum Kuroti Vacharam Pangur Langyate Kirim Yakripata Mahambandeshi Guru Jivatari. By the mercy of Guru, even a dumb person become very good speaker, Vachak. By the mercy of Guru, a person who has no legs can jump, catch the moon. And a foolish person may become wonderful, expert. So Baladev is Guru. By his mercy, this Ugrasrava became the most qualified personality. So, anyway, so sometimes Baladev is very astonishing like that. It seems Baladev was so much partial to Duryodhana. And Krishna was partial to Bhim. So during the war, these two disciples were fighting at the end. Balaram mostly carries a club. Balorde is very expert in all type of fighting. But generally, when possible, he tries to avoid it. But all knowledge he gave to Duryodhana and Bhishma. So the end of the Mahabharata, these two were surviving. Guru Maharaj one time told the guitar that Duryodhana was hiding in the lake, and by his mystic power, he covered the lake. Nobody knew where he was. But some hunters had seen Duryodhana enter the lake, so they told the Pandavas, Duryodhana is there. So Yudhisthira came. Oh, Duryodhana, come and fight, because the war is not over, because Duryodhana is still alive. So Duryodhana was very sad because all his brothers, 100 brothers killed, all his uncles, his guru, all family members killed. So Duryodhana said, I am very tired, I cannot fight, I give you the kingdom. I give the kingdom to you. That time Yudhisthira became very angry. We asked, just give us 5 villages. You said, I did not give you enough land to push a pin into it. And now you're so generous, you give us the earth planet as a donation. You just say, we are Kshatriyas, we do not accept donation. We are not Brahmanas, we are Kshatriyas. Then Duryodhana said, choose any of us 5 brothers with a fight to the death. Who wins becomes king. That time the other brothers chastised Yudhisthira. Yudhisthira, what foolishness you're saying. Who can defeat Duryodhana? And Nakula and Sahadeva were not so strong, like Arjuna, for example. That time the Pandavas quickly had a meeting. We elect Bhima as our king.
Guru Maharaj one time told this kata.
We elect Bhima as our king. So Duryodhana was very happy because he too much hated Bhima. And she had said, he would practice on a wooden, on a steel statue of Bhima for many years. He would fight. So this fighting was going on. So Bhima was more strong, but Duryodhana was more skillful. Therefore, their qualities nullified each other's quality. They were fighting. Then finally, who will win? So Arjuna asked Krishna very loudly, oh Krishna, who will win this war? Bhima is more strong, but Duryodhana is more skillful. How is it possible? How will Bhima defeat him? That time Krishna caught the eye of Bhima and went like this. Because when they tried to make Draupadi without cloth, that time Duryodhana had shown his naked thigh and said, sit here, slave. Now you are our property. Sit here. Accept the lap of your master. Very disrespectful words to Draupadi. That time Bhima had promised, I will smash this with my cloth. So when Krishna did this, he reminded Bhima of your promise. Also, we'll wait for Maharaj, we keep speaking. This was the only place Duryodhana could be killed. Gurudev would sometimes tell funny guitar, very amusing guitar for Mahabharata. Duryodhana's mother, Gandhari, because her husband was blind, she also accepted voluntary blindness by covering her eyes. By the power of her chastity, she did with so much mystic power. So she said to her son, you come to me naked, nighttime, and I will transfer all my power to your body. So Duryodhana nighttime was going to his mother completely naked. Mother said, come naked. That time by providence, he met Krishna on the path. Then Krishna saw him. Hey man, what are you doing? Walking around like this. I'm going to see my mother. Come on man, at least cover yourself here. So Krishna gave him 1 banana leaf. So when he went in the tent, then he said, mother, I am here. Then Gandhari raised her blindfold and all her power she put in the body of Duryodhana. But because he was covered by banana leaf, this is the only place he could be killed. So Krishna did all this by slapping his eyes. He reminded Bhima, remember your promise to smash his thighs? So Bhima did that and crushed his nether regions.
Then dancing on his head with his foot.
No, because Bhim had no beard or mustache. Therefore, cow had no beard or mustache. So Duryodhana used to make fun of Bhim by calling him a cow. So Bhim stamped on his head. Am I a cow now? Stamped on his head. This was great disrespect and cheating also. When Balaram saw this, Balaram became very angry. Balaram wanted to go and kill Bhim at that time. So angry. But when he understood this is Krishna's desire. So Balaram had desire, but when his desire came in conflict with Balaram, then with Krishna, then Balaram always declined his desire. Sometimes we may have one desire and Guru Vaishnava had another desire. That time our desire should not come in conflict, we should give up our own guru, give up our own desire. But this is not... Sometimes someone has too much desire, I will do this. When Guru Vaishnava had another desire, then when someone desire very strong, what can I do? But Baladev always give up his desire when he understands Krishna has some other desire. Anyway, so Baladev, so many pastimes in Braj, he's like Krishna's shadow. Krishna, Balaram born 8 days before Krishna. So, together they grew up, together they crawled, together they, Sadhu Maharaj was speaking. So Vrindavan, many people, they celebrate Balaram chant. They have a philosophy. Balaram was born 1 year before Krishna. The Guru Maharaj would speak against this. How Bhagavatam not describes. Balaram, the Bhagavatam described Krishna and Balaram, same time they got a name. Same time they took Diksha, Upanayan. So therefore we not accept that Balaram was born 1 year before, we accept Balaram born 8 days before. So, Balaram, too much important, any weakness we have, any defect, then we pray to Baladev, he gives shelter, he will form us, he gives us strength, so he gives us everything. So what can we say? Shri Balaram Prabhu Ki Jai. Maharaj? Okay, so, just keep, Dear Hari, will you come and speak something for us? Come, Maharaj is not coming. Pradabjibu, first, you want to speak something? Come speak while Maharaj is coming, then come speak. Katha should go on. Come on, hurry up. Give a seat here, Balaram. Balaram, it has something to do with Pradabjibu. Hare Krishna.
You can sit here, Maharaj.
Padabhya, come on.
Krishna Prabhu Nityananda Goswami Maharaj.